Today let's study about the ring opening reactions of oxirenes, that is epoxide. Okay, epoxides are three-membered heterocyclic compounds with an oxygen atom. These cyclic compounds can be broken into linear compounds by either acid or base catalyst reactions, which is given here. Here I have taken ethylene epoxide, which can be broken. So these are the products. Okay, fine. In case of symmetrical epoxides like this, there is no confusion about the site of nucleophilic attack, because the nucleophile can attack this carbon or this carbon, no problem, and I'll get the products. But when it comes to unsymmetrical oxirenes like this, okay, and the site of nucleophilic attack, if it differs, it will result in different products formation. See, for example, if the nucleophile attacks this carbon, okay, I'll get this product, whereas if the nucleophile attacks here, then it will result in this product. So likewise, the base catalyst reactions, if the methoxide ion attacks here, then I'll get this product, whereas if it attacks this carbon, I'll get this product. Okay. Now, to understand this, let us see the mechanism of ring opening in acid catalyst reactions. So the oxygen atom in epoxide will get protonated first, and protonation follows by the ring opening. So the ring can either open at this carbon and oxygen, or this carbon and oxygen. I'm going to call this carbon oxygen bond, that is this carbon, as a type ring opening, whereas if this carbon oxygen bond breaks, I'm going to call it as B type. This is to examine what kind of intermediate that can be resulted due to this bond breakage. Okay, if A type bond breakage happens, then it will leads to secondary carbocation, whereas a B type will give me primary carbocation. As the secondary carbocation is more stable than primary carbocation, the major product will result from these more stable secondary carbocation intermediate. Likewise, base catalyst reactions also here, and this methoxide ion can attack here or here. I'm going to call it as A type attack if it attacks this carbon. If it attacks at this carbon, I'm going to call it as a B type attack. Okay, so A type attack is more predominant, and the major product will result from it. So we can conclude that in acid catalyst reaction, the nucleophile attacks at the more hindered position, and it follows SN1 type of reaction. Whereas in base catalyst reaction, the nucleophile attacks at the less hindered carbon. It looks like a more SN2 type of reaction. Okay, so again I tell you, in acid catalyst reactions, the nucleophile attacks the more hindered carbon, and in base catalyst reaction, the nucleophile attacks the less hindered carbon. Now, Grignard reagent will also react with epoxide, and it proceeds via SN2 mechanism. You can see here, so the methyl anion attacks at the less hindered carbon, and subsequent ring opening to give the final product. Okay, fine. Now, I have two different side chains. One is methyl and another one is ethyl. Methyl is less hindered, whereas ethyl is a much bulkier group. That's why the alkyl anion, that is a methyl anion, attacks here to give the product. Okay, fine. Now, here is an interesting case of ring opening. We have CH2Br group that is present in the side chain, and it is a base catalyst reaction, and it is going to follow SN2 reaction, okay, SN2 type. The ethoxide ion attacks at the less hindered carbon, whereas here, and subsequent ring opening. However, in the intermediate, the oxide ion goes for a nucleophilic attack on the methylene carbon, okay, this carbon, and subsequent bromine will be eliminated, and the ring closure happens again, okay. This reaction doesn't follow under Williamson's ether synthesis, but is an example for neighboring group participation in substitution reactions. We have a problem, okay, here A reacts with methyl magnesium iodide to give me this compound, okay, when I take propine reacts with sodamide and liquid ammonia followed by A treatment. I am going to add A to get the product B. Now I need to find out the structure of B. Okay, surely from the example, from the first reaction, I can understand that A must be an epoxide. Okay, since a methyl group is present here, then 1, 2 with an oxygen, which means it must be a ethylene epoxide only. So A must be ethylene epoxide. Now I understand that sodamide is a very strong base, so it would have removed this hydrogen and subsequent generation of this species. Okay, and so when I have an epoxide ring like this, then this CH3C triple bond C, this ion would have attacked here and the ring would have opened like this. So A will be the answer. Thank you guys. Happy learning.